83 claims going to Surrey Hills. You grab that for us?
Picking up from you at level 4. And where are we going to?
Hey! Twat! Catch you later, Luke. 48, boss. Who put this hill here on such a lovely day?
Yeah. 84 fifth going to skin cancer. Any chance you knock it off for us? Drop number 9296 is a VIP.
You're running across the city like a maniac to pick up a cheque for several $100 million sometimes, and these have got to be paid by 11 o'clock in the morning, otherwise they're not allowed to trade again for that afternoon.
So we need the money in right away, because it's first in best dress.
Skater, I'm hoping to do an exclusive to Turner by 11:30, but there's a patient in the chair at 11:30.
Okay, gotcha.
I sort of left school and started with Royal Mail, working for the post office. I was an apprentice, so I suppose I was 15, 16. For about 20 years I've been doing it. Yeah, basically all my working life as a courier. A boy on a bike, I'm 35 years old and I'm still looking at it as a career move. It is a rewarding job when you see what you do at the end of the day. These moves get made. We're all part of it, because we are the quickest possible way around town.
Freedom is probably a huge part of why I like it so much. There's nobody sitting on your shoulder. You know, you're not in a small confined space. You've got lots of different things happening. I just consider it the same as an office job, really, but I just have a bigger office, that's all.
So initially I took it up because of the adrenaline of riding through town and to keep me reflexes up and my fitness up for my racing. I just got hooked. The adrenaline just grabbed me. Whoa! Why? I think I've had about 17, 18 operations. Broken both my wrists many times. I've had them reconstructed. Both of them had many operations on my wrists. My knees are the same. This has had like 6 operations now, 4 reconstructions, a bad infection.
There's a bit of play in that, but it's actually at least you've got an end point. So that ligament's managed to hold together despite the falls you have. Your kneecap's never come out?
No. I can feel that in my belly though when you do that.
Right. So all the scars have healed up well. We'll see what you can break next.
Can't believe it, I got a $7.5 million check in my bag and I get paid $2 to take it, eh?
I'd like to make a booking. We need a non-stop actually, super urgent. Yes, we need it there in about 30 minutes.
Okay, job number will be 9145.
48, Danny.
48. Like a lightning flash. Boss, on my crystals, I have 6 on.
These are the plans going across to Piedmont?
Absolutely.
Excellent, thank you very much.
Have a good day.
You too. Bye.
Oh, spin the gap! Shaggy, there we go! Red light! Red light, yellow light, green light, go! Shaggy, there!
Casey.
Yeah.
Does he take me all the way up, eh, bro?
Yeah, level 6, mate. He's up there in the room.
Is this safe or what, this lift?
Ah, oh, hang on.
Mark. This is the man. Mark, how are your plans, dude?
Thank you very much. Been waiting for us for a while, mate.
Oh, hopefully not more than 20 minutes. Because it's Friday and we're alive. It's Friday and we're alive.
I'll be lucky to finish today with $40. It costs about $40 or $50 a day, minimum, to actually keep on the road. So, yeah, I've run out of loss today. Me and Danny first met right in the middle of the road. We were on for a head-on crash, and it was just like, oh, well, he's the same as me, I'm the same as him. So we just stopped and we got to know each other. He was a teenage star, wasn't he? He was the BMX champ, old Fluoro. Well on his way up there for the Worlds and things. A few bad injuries, and that's where the bad attitude comes from. So he's been in it all his life. It's in his blood for good, I guess. You know, natural-born courier now.
7:48, Danny. No, and the Surrey to North Sydney, which you've got on, is also VIP. Coming due in about 15, no worries.
Ah, Robin's racing! Whooshka! Gotta get this blood to the blood bank, mate. Whoa! I just hit that dude, eh? Sure he would do that, eh?
And we've had a large number of complaints related to pedestrians actually being victimised by bike riders.
We've also had them driving through red lights and having accidents. We've had some memorable chases where the police on bikes have chased the couriers on bikes. This day we've won most of those races. We've lost a few.
Some of the complaints we've had is what they call the three S's: swearing, spitting and speeding.
Oi! What?
Just getting around the city in general is a hazard. The fact that you've actually got to achieve something in a certain amount of time as well in itself is a hazard.
I reckon you could time your life sometimes within seconds. You know, a car passes you and you think, oh, 2 seconds earlier and that would have been me at the front of that car.
On some occasions, we actually get applause from members of the public when the bicycle riders are stopped.
Bike couriers have killed people in the city of Sydney, and I am convinced they will kill again. Habitual murderers. No news today, so let's pick on the couriers, you know. They've got the royal family in Britain, they've got the Kennedys in America, and they've got couriers in Sydney, isn't it?
There was a picture of me, and it was just saying, well, these are bicycle couriers, and we've taken photos of them, and they're all breaking the law. They stereotype us by thinking we all are reckless. We all love to run red lights, and we all get some kind of satisfaction about doing that.
One of the problems we have, if in a motor vehicle and we're caught up in the flow of traffic and they're coming the other way, by the time we stopped and turned around, they'd have moved off. That's why we use the police on push bikes as a, not just a deterrent, but it's fighting fire with fire.
Better get a lawyer, son. You Better get real. Better get a lawyer, son. You better get a real good one.
Hello, who are you? What do you want? Talk to me and it better be good. I'm going home.
Hey, Danny, dude, yeah. Just a warning call, mate. Your two favourite coppers are out again. Yeah, they're going to get you. If you give them a chase, Danny, they'll get you, dude. You know it. You know it. Okay, gotcha.
Shop number 1014, back to Gould Street and Broadway, St. Peter.
Over the last 3.5 years, there's probably been 20 or 30 different operations targeting the bicycle couriers. And one of the key elements of that has been the closed-circuit television coverage throughout the city. There's now, I think, over 50 cameras from the southern end to the northern end of the city. It's been a very, very successful program. They might end up with $200 or $300 or $400 worth of fines on any given day. But these people also insist that their profession, their livelihood is based on getting doing the deliveries on time. And if they don't get it done on time, they don't get paid in many instances.
We are responsible for, you know, what we do on the road, but we're also responsible to our clients and they kind of call the shots.
When the police are out and in the city, some of the riders just put their heads down and go flat stick, because they can't afford to get caught. I got nailed big time, cost me like $4,000 in fines.
They see it's part of their job is to break the law, and they recognise that it's our job to enforce it.
$1,600 worth of warrants and fines paid the other day. Means I can now break the law again, like, you know, running my lights and stuff like that without being worried of being pulled over and locked up.
It annoys some of them for a couple of days, but then they probably have to cheat more to make up for the money that they've had to pay in fines.
But he's not going to go out.